most respected President, respected Secretary, friends. After 53 years of practice in general medicine, I have come to the conclusion, certain diseases ought to be treated by everybody. Diabetes is to be treated by everybody. Hypertension is to be treated by everybody. Hypothyroidism is to be treated by everybody. Unless we adopt this policy, and fortunately we have been successful in diabetes, impressing upon the governments of India and Tamil Nadu, that every practitioner should treat diabetes. Same way I am convinced every practitioner should treat hypothyroidism. These are the sponsors and the sponsors where we speak. The first thing in hypothyroidism is diagnosis. Friends, over the period of time, by the impact of the so-called specialist, there has been a tendency to do only this. Avoiding to do T3 and T4. Please revert back to old. T3, T4, THS is to be done, and the interpretation of the result of THS is to be based on the values of T4, T3 also. This becomes more important when you are going to treat subclinical hypothyroidism. Therefore, the diagnosis of primary hypothyroidism is THS elevated, T3, T4 diminished.
Possible.
Is it 3T3 or 3T4? You can do both if you can, the patient can afford. 3 is better, right? Possible. If the patient has got, the fluorid signs of hypothyroidism, along with the laboratory support of TSS increase and T3 decrease, treat. Here again, very unfortunately, the human mind is a very good mind, is a criminal mind. Human mind and specialists, when the THS is very much high, start with 50-100. Please don't do that. Till today, despite all the intensive care units and other things, a direct correlation between blood sugar and insulin therapy has not been successful in all the patients, has not been uniform in all the patients. Same way, the necessity of thyroxine replacement will not be uniform in all the patients. A one-to-one basis, when you are treating a patient in your office, start with 12.5. Every 3 weeks, go on increasing till you optimize the laboratory result. Clinical features are absolutely non-specific. But patients have come to you for this in over hypothyroidism. He is not bothered about what you treat, he is not bothered, he wants to be relieved. The lady wants to get up in the morning and attend to the husband and children, send them to work. She is not bothered what the level of thyroxine. Therefore, let us attend to the clinical picture also, which has been very aptly emphasized by my esteemed colleague Lakshmi Narayan in the beginning of the talk. Possible. When it comes to subclinical treatment, which is now the order of the day, to find the disease early, when you come to subclinical treatment, diagnosis, and replacement therapy, please follow these guidelines. This has been accepted throughout. The laboratory value of the normality of THS will vary from laboratory to laboratory. High tech 4.5. If you go to Lister, 5.5. If you go to some other lab, respect them, because they do the methodology and they give you the laboratory value. When it is less than 10, if the patient has got a fluorid hypothyroidism treatment. Otherwise, treatment of value of TSH anywhere between normal, say 5.5 to 10, depends on these factors. If you are treating along with the rise with THS any of these things, family history, presence of goiter, lady wanting to become pregnant, treat. Otherwise, wait. Therefore, asymptomatic subclinical hypothyroidism with a THS value from upper limit of normal to 10, please observe. Unless there is a specific indication to treat. Repeat it every 3 months and then see. If there is a rise of titer of THS, start treating. One person comes to you, the first value is 6.8, no treatment, observe, 3 weeks, 8.8, start treating. Therefore, the value of THS between upper limit of normal to 10 is an area to be observed, correlated with the other clinical features. Therefore, I emphasize, hypothyroidism is treated to everybody. Laboratory values, go by all the three parameters, flow rate clinical signs, treat, low dose to higher dose. Then, when you avoid a borderline TSH, you have more than 10 treat between borderline. Please go by clinical presentation. Next, positive. Then I will go to another area where treatment positive pregnancy problem. Where another area treatment is satisfying and satisfying to the patient, satisfying the future patient. Patient is a mother, Munari. 2.53 man. Yeah, Marishna also for that. Tension.
It is not stuck actually.
Yes, sir. Now, throughout the world, the initiative should go to the Indian Thyroid Society, to the Amarnandamayi Institute of Medical Sciences, Cochin, who are the leaders in this development. Of course, Glaxo Group owns the foreign. I always have contempt for foreign national companies, they always go to the white man. They have a respect to the white man, less respect to the black man. But this one has been done by the Mata Amarnandamayi Institute, and they have co-funded this, which has been endorsed by the American Thyroid Society. When you have got a pregnant lady, first trimester, second trimester, third trimester, even if she is absolutely normal, and most of them, 99% of the people are absolutely normal at that age group, which is my experience in association with my wife, I am attending to a maternity hospital, this should be treated. The video is Google accept. Google has got a very sensation. Some of the slides they don't accept, therefore we may not go to it. Right.
Google says you don't project and monetize the video.
Okay.
If it is somebody else's. If it is your own, you can monetize.
No, it's not mine. Obviously it's not mine.
No, we are going to monetize any video. So
therefore, first trimester, 0.1 to 2.5, second trimester 0.2 to 3, third trimester 0.3 to 3. If the value exceeds whichever point of time you see the pregnant mother, start treating. Because I'm not going to predict the further slides, I'm going to close. There has been very great success in two endocrine areas in treating the pregnant mother. One is gestational diabetes mellitus, second is hypothyroidism. By treating gestational diabetes mellitus, I am making the child euglycemic. We are postponing the development of diabetes. Lakshmanandan will watch for it for 2 decades. That's a very important success we have achieved in the treatment of prevention of diabetes mellitus. Same way, the mental development and faculty and development of the child fetus is enhanced by keeping the mother euthyroid at this level. These values will be normal for a non-pregnant adult woman or a man. But for a pregnant lady, they are abnormal. This has been accepted worldwide. Therefore, when it comes to this, please treat. Again, start with the low dose. Monitor once in a month and then treat. Of course, once in a month, some people find it difficult to be monitored twice a month. Therefore, pregnancy in hypothyroidism is a special area where treatment is effective. How long you continue? Till delivery, 4 weeks after delivery. Then you stop it. Here is an area of hypothyroidism where definitely treatment for 9 months gives excellent result to the mother and child. With this I will close. Any question not related even to the 4 stages I have presented, I welcome to answer. I thank the Glaxo for giving me an opportunity. has succeeded making me prescribe naproxen as practitioner. Very is great source. I am able to help them because the volume of patients I am seeing in the therapy hospital. Thank you. Any questions? Any comments? Personal experiences?
Why you ask for T3 and T4 not only instead of only T6? Because that only we
actually right. I have not touched upon the thyroid peroxidase because I thought I should finish by 6:30 ago. When see THS helping for the high tech laboratory value 4.5 normal. 6.5. Now to say whether the person is hypothyroid or not, 6.5 alone, if you rely, you may not be correct. If you correlate a 3T4, it is borderline lower. I mean, you know, microgram put on 160 working point T3 over the T4. And the borderline lower, you are more sure. Therefore, now we should revert back to doing all the three tests.
Chansey very rightly said about the importance of testing for thyroid in pregnancy. But regarding this T3, T4 estimation, when we see a patient with a TSH increase, not necessarily subclinical hypothyroidism, not necessarily decrease the T3, T4, not decrease. So several times we have to depend on the TSH low to start treating the patient. And how often we can repeat once in a month, once 3 months, it is not feasible because estimating all costs around 500 rupees. And diabetes is another common cause where the subclinical hypothyroidism coexists. So always those who are treating diabetes, please do TSH levels, if necessary T3, T4 levels also.
Thank you.